Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
My name's Joseph. I'm from Oak Ridge, Tennessee. My worst bullying experience was in gym class, where this guy pulled out a Bible on me and told me I was going to hell and there was nothing I could do to prevent it. And when I asked him the question, like, aren't Christians supposed to love everybody? Isn't that what God's trying to teach everybody? He replied and said, I love gays the way I love murderers and prostitutes. And that's so far from the truth. Like, murderers and prostitutes are completely different than gay people, you know? Being gay, you don't hurt anybody. There's nothing to take away from society by being gay. I want to be religious, but I don't see why I should go to a church when God doesn't even like me. I don't understand why he doesn't like me, because aren't we all supposed to be God's children and he created us equal, but yet the gay people he doesn't like. I thought about committing suicide my freshman year. It was right after I came out, and I was experiencing a lot of teasing during that time. And I didn't know how to handle it because I was still new to it. I was still trying to find ways to cope with it. And just one night, I decided it wasn't worth, like, what I go through on a daily basis just for being who I am. And if people didn't want to accept me for who I was, then I should, you know, just not be me. I shouldn't even be here. So I remember one night I was listening to some songs, and I was getting so upset. I really didn't know why. What I did that was so horrible for nobody to accept me. So I remember I got some sleeping pills, and I went to my room, and my plan was that I would take the sleeping pills and I would drink the antifreeze, so I would die peacefully in my sleep. And the first thought that came into my mind was, like, what about my mom? She, like, means so much to me. I don't want her to go through that pain of losing her son. She doesn't deserve that, you know. She's been there for me forever. She provided for me. And she's such an inspiration. And I didn't want to let her down like that, you know. She raised someone who was much stronger than that. And then something else popped in my head. It was, what about my little sister? What is my little sister going to think when she finds out that her big brother committed suicide? The one who's supposed to be all tough and, like, you know, goes through everything without shedding a tear. What's she going to think? And then, if she's going through bullying, I did not want that to be in her head, because I just didn't want her to give her the thought of, being, you know, committing suicide just because you're being bullied. I had to show her that you have to remain strong. Sorry, I get so emotional talking about suicide, 'cause I almost took my own life. I just didn't want the people who were bullying me, I didn't want them to feel like they won also. Like they found my breaking spot, they found my weakness, and that ultimately means they win. But I knew if I wanted to show them that they, you know, weren't better than me, all I had to do was just walk in and act like everything was okay, paint this big old smile on my face, and just walk in with my head held high. I knew, like, that would get to them, besides, like, taking my life, because then, like, they win. My idol is Adam Lambert. He is not ashamed in who he is, and he inspires me to just take pride in being gay. My dream is to become a dad and a husband one of these days. I do feel like we are on, like, the verge of acceptance from everybody. And hopefully, by the time I'm old enough, I could be able to have a husband and a kid and have a nice family. That's my ultimate goal. It's just to be a great dad and a husband. So, hopefully it'll come true.
I'm Allie, I'm 17, I'm transgender, I'm from Stuttgart, Arkansas, and I just graduated from high school. I realized that I was meant to be a girl when I was 3 years old. I would put on my grandma's wigs, her long t-shirts, and tie rope around me as a dress, and wear her high heels and walk around the house, calling myself Sarah.
I wear jeans and a t-shirt and try to blend in as a boy when I walk around town.
I never really considered myself a boy. But during high school years, I was considered myself as a gay male because that was easier to explain than saying I'm transgender, and people would understand that more, and I felt they would accept that a little bit more than saying I am transgender.
Why do I get called a faggot? Why do I get called loser? And why do I get called a freak? Am I a freak? I don't know. I just want to be happy with who I am. Why can't I just be? Why can't people just let me be me? Why do they feel the need to tear me down? I'm a nice person. They don't see that. All they see is that I don't fit with their normal, what they consider normal. All I'm doing is just doing what I view as what a girl would do. And they don't like that. Why is it so hard for them to grasp that as long as it's not hurting you, don't worry about it? Like, I don't understand why they feel the need to make someone's life a living hell when they don't like it. Why they feel the need to get involved in everybody else's business when it doesn't even pertain to them. I'm just another person in school. I really love Ellen DeGeneres. I have a picture of her on my wall, and I idolize her. She's a strong and confident woman, and she's out and proud about who she is, and she doesn't care if people like it or not. She's just out there and open about everything, and I hope to be just like her one day. I'm excited because I'm finally finding who I am and becoming a new woman. I'm starting college pretty soon, and I hope to become a famous transgender psychologist and help the transgender community.